baseball fans, and welcome. The World Series on MLB The Show coming up. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Texas Rangers. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. And a lot riding on this one as these teams meet for game two, Chris.
And the series started out like you might expect, the home side taking care of business in game one. But this game today is going to reveal a lot about what this series will become. Will it be a battle for six or seven games, or will it be a walkover? Those are the questions that we start getting more clarity on after game two.
I have a feeling it's going to be a good one, Chris. This should be fun. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Almost ready to get underway. And our pitcher tonight, Jordan Montgomery. What do you have on him?
A really good outing for him last time. Scattered two runs, was attacking hitters, getting ahead in the count. Great performance. We'll see if he can do it again in this one.
And now, Jake McCarthy.
Leading off tonight for Arizona, the right fielder, Jake McCarthy.
Ball to strike, the pitch. And that's in for a strike. And a ball evens the count. Kicks and fires. Next offering misses down and away. And so the lefty allows the leadoff free pass.
No, very close with the location right there. It's just tough to get rewarded on the call with pitches near the top of the strike zone.
Here's Tommy Pham. The pitch. There's a swing and a miss. Here's a 1-2. McCarthy on at first. Nobody out. Pitch misses outside. The count now 2-2. And there's a fly ball deep right field. That one opts against the fence. Garcia throws to second. Not in time. It's a double. And they'll score first. It's 1-0.
He was all over that one. You see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time, 106.
This is Corbin Carroll. 2-2 now. Bounce to the left side. Over to Lowe. One out in the top of the first. Now the Diamondbacks lineup as put together by Torrey Lovello. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team, and I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Fly ball pretty well struck right field. That's back there. That's down. One hops off the wall. Pham around third. He scores, and they lead by two.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Thank you. And another ball.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners with one out.
Everything came together for him. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. The other way. That's a base hit as a run scores. And that rolls into the corner. And he's in safely at third as a run scores.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Now it's Evan Longoria's turn. And he deals. Called strike right there.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
Here comes a pitch. Misses. It's 2-2.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
Got him looking for the strikeout. And a big sigh of relief from the mound with that called third strike.
Oh, nice job right there. He struck him out twice. The pitch before looked like it was strike three. Doesn't get the call. Bears down. Throws another quality pitch for the strikeout.
Gabriel Moreno, the next to hit. That misses, two balls and a strike.
Well, it stinks to be down by, you know, these runs early in this ballgame like this, but you've got two outs, you've got to close the door because you still have a chance with how much time is left in this one.
On the ground, and he grabs it, foul. So 40 pitches already, still just in the first inning. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. One run is in. Another scores. Two runs in on the play. It's 5-0.
Nicely done. Brings home two. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Jordan Lawler stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Step off throw to first. Moreno back on a dive. Here's a 1-1. That clips the corner.
Well, it's not the inning he was planning on to begin this start, but you've got to find a way to shake things off and give your team some length and put up some zeros.
Next one just misses. Ball two.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Line drive, and it's into the gap. Moreno around second, headed for third. Across is the runner from first, and it's now a 6-run lead.
Comes through with the RBI. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced, and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Jordan Montgomery will depart. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. Taking over on the mound for the Rangers, Martin Perez.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. And now the right fielder, Jake McCarthy. He walked and came around to score his first time up. Runner at second, two down. Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third. There's a ball. Throw to third. Save.
Very risky right there to try to steal third with two outs and a left-hander at the plate. And there's an open lane for that catcher to throw down. But he gambled. Now he's at third, 90 feet closer. Perhaps a ball in the dirt that gets away from the catcher, and they pick up a run.
And down on strikes he goes. Inning over, although plenty of damage done. So in the end, 10 men come to the plate. Six of them come around to score. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Diamondback six, and the Rangers coming to bat. Back here at the ballpark, and on the hill, Merrill Kelly.
Last time out, it just seemed like he wasn't trusting his stuff. He fell behind in the count, walked a number of guys. Today, he's got to pitch aggressively, and he's got to pitch inside.
We go to the bottom of the first. Digging in, Evan Carter.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
Righty delivers. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Next offering misses. And that's ball two. Foul ball there.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. Not stopping. He's going for three. Cut off, throw to third. In there safely.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Man, that feels so good to shoot an absolute bolt the opposite way. Split the gap and know that you've got extra bases right off the bat. That's the kind of thing hitters dream about when they're falling asleep at night. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Runner at third with one gone. Next up for Texas, Corey Seager. Kicks and deals. And misses inside. Tavares takes his lead at third with one away. Next one is off the plate. Now 3-1. And there's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Adolis Garcia stepping in for the Rangers.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
2-1 down. Grounder might be two. To second for one. And it's a double play to end the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. We head to the second in Arlington. It's the Diamondback six and the Rangers nothing. And welcome back. New inning getting started. Now the number two hitter, Tommy Pham.
Tommy Pham.
Check swing, went around, and it's 2-2. swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Corbin Carroll. He's 0 for 1. And a pitch. And now 2-1. That one missed.
Larry Bullard making the calls behind the plate for us in this one. Pretty good strike zone. Well reviewed by those we talked to around the league.
Yeah, he's an umpire. He doesn't get a lot of looks from players. Maybe here and there once in a while, but he's appreciated back there. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
He must have been looking for something else because he gave up on that pitch a little early. It was right down Main Street. Probably not going to see a better pitch to hit in this at-bat.
Left-hand batter waits. To the right side, Semien. On the run, throw to first. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
Now batter, the first baseman, Christian.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's a big power threat. Christian Walker doubled in his first AB. The wind of the pitch. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And now it's filled up. Ketel Marte to bat next. The pitch. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
That's a nice at bat and a great take on 3-2. Probably could have gone either way in that spot around the knees.
So two down. Here's Ketel Marte. Singled and scored his first time. Line to left and foul ball. Next offering is down low. And that's ball three.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Semien, toss over to first. They get the out on Marte. And the inning is over. No runs, no hits, no errors, and a runner left. We go to the bottom of inning number two. It's the Diamondbacks 6 and the Rangers nothing. Welcome back. Bottom half of inning number 2. Now it's Marcus Semien. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. And that is cut on and missed. 1-2.
Boog, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Towards first. Walker takes it to the bag and quickly one away in the second.
The first baseman.
Nathaniel Lowe up to hit.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field, but he can jump you if you make a mistake.
And that one is lifted in the air. Diving, it gets down. Could be extra bases. Lowe into second, and he's got a double.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Put a really nice balanced swing on it, and when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box, and he'll feel real good about that one.
Ezekiel Duran stepping in for the Rangers. And a 1-2. cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
Low on its second with two down. To third, Longoria. Tosses to first, and that is the third out of the inning. A double in the inning, but they leave them stranded. We play two full. It's the Diamondback six, and the Rangers nothing. Back here at the ballpark, top half of the third inning. Here's Gurriel. And here it comes. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The pitch. Ground ball to the right side, and that's just foul. Swing and a miss, and he's down on strikes, and the struggles continue in the postseason. Now the third baseman, Evan Longoria. His first at bat was a strikeout. Ball and a strike. And a big swing and a miss.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
The wide to kick the pitch. The punch out there. That's his second strikeout.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed, it's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. He tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
On the ground, Simeon. And that is that. Diamondbacks down quickly. They lead it, though, 6-0. And welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now the catcher for the Rangers, Jonah Heim. Right-hander kicks, deals. Heim checks his swing, appeal to third, and he won a round. Ruled a swing. So the lineup flips over. Up next for the Rangers, Evan Carter. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. Here's a 2-2. And there's a rocket into the outfield.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Here's Leody Tavares. That's off the mark, and that's ball three. And ball four to a board. And here's Corey Seager to hit. He reached out a walk his first time.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there, he owns the home plate area.
Next pitch inside, and it's 2-1.
Tough spot right here, couple runners on, two ball count. you can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss, and he got him to chase.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Next offering way off the plate. Two on, one out. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, I think that was just a case of a hitter quitting on a pitch. He was looking fastball and didn't see it out of the hand and just left the bat on his shoulder. That was a changeup right over the plate. Probably not the location he was looking for, but the change of speeds is what fooled him, and he got the out.
Falling behind 2-1. And the right-hander deals. That one the other way. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Rangers leave a pair. They still find themselves down 6-0. As we go to the top of the fourth, and now the shortstop, Jordan Lawler.
Jordan Lawler.
Bounce to the right side, and it goes just foul. The wind of the pitch. Liner, base hit.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night, and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. So the batting order turns over. Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. The 3-1. Swing and a bouncer. He beats it out, and it's first and second on the infield single. The play. Tommy Pham, 1-for-2 with an RBI double back in the first. And a 1-1. Line drive, base hit right field. Lawler around third. The throw's offline, he's safe. And they're pulling away up by 7 now.
That's now 3 hits in a row for the offense. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep. Took the barrel right to it and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Corbin Carroll getting ready to hit the 1-1. Swings through the fastball up in the zone.
Well, these Diamondbacks putting together some really good at-bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. 5 of their hits have come from at-bats where they were behind in the count, so they're really battling up there.
And a ball and 2 strikes. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. No outs, runners at first and second. That's off the mark, 2-2.
And even if they don't want to make it a habit of falling behind, they're doing a great job of making the most out of it. I think that's contagious throughout the lineup.
Little trouble with this one behind the plate. But no advance from the runners. The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out. 2-1 with 1 out. And now it's Christian Walker. McCarthy on second. Pham at first. 1 gone. Next offering is foul back. pitch. On the ground to the left. And foul ball. Here's a 1-2. And that one missing low. Got it by him for the K. Stepping in, Ketel Marte. Singled and scored back in the first. He's 1-for-2. First and second, 2 down. That one down the line, and that's just foul. Out to short. They take the force out. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Diamondbacks 7 and the Rangers nothing. Bottom four. Now it's the second baseman, Marcus Semien.
The second baseman, Marcus.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and one out now.
Up next to the Rangers.
Here's Nathaniel Lowe. Doubled his first time up. Next one misses, and it's 2-1.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at-bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
The 2-1. And that one a little bit high.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking and make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, that's a really good take right there, and that's just mentally prepared, knowing that if it's not on a tee, you're going to take that pitch because you still have one more strike to work with. Not easy to lay off, but he did an excellent job in that plate appearance.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Got it! Covered plenty of distance there. And there are 2 down.
The third baseman, number 6, Josh Young.
Here's Josh Young. First time up, he grounded to third. Next offering is in for a strike. Two outs. Swing and a tapper. That is the inning. Nothing across on no hits, no errors, and one man left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Diamondbacks 7 and the Rangers nothing. So out of the bullpen for the Rangers, Dane Dunning.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr., 1-for-2. Right-handed reliever. He swings and fouls one off.
You know, these D-backs really impressing me with the quality of their at-bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in. So I'd say mission accomplished.
2-2 down. On the ground to first, and he picks it up in foul territory. Chopped left side. Over to Lowe. One up, one down.
The third baseman, number three, Evan Longoria.
Here's the third baseman, Evan Longoria, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. The 2-2. In the air, left field, down the line. Durant makes the grab on the run.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Jonathan Hernandez up and throwing. Righty to the plate. And that's outside. And that's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
And the righty deals and delivers outside.
Two balls, one strike.
And the 2-2. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Moreno leads off first with two down to the inning. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
They just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
See, I think just our presence is the present. Back to the top of the lineup. Now up next for Arizona, Jake McCarthy. The pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count's even at two.
Well, and those hitters' counts sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
2-2. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Line drive, base hit. Moreno coming home. Now a long throw home. The run comes in to score from second. It's 8-0. And he's got a double.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
And now the center fielder, Tommy Pham.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
The 1-2.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like, he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
And now it's filled up.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Corbin Carroll in the on-deck circle. And a pitch. Base hit and a run in to score. He's in there.
Love how he became a really tough out with two strikes right there. Nice job going the opposite way with it, letting the ball travel and not allowing the barrel to hook around the ball. It's so frustrating when you see a good pitch and your hands roll over. It was on the outside part of the plate, and he approached it perfectly.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Jonathan Hernandez.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
Now at the plate, Corbin Carroll. Here comes a pitch. Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate, and the runner holds. Hernandez throws over. Bam, back to first safely. Next pitch misses way outside. Christian Walker waiting for a turn at the plate. Kicks and deals. And there's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Next to hit for Arizona, Christian Walker. A strikeout and a walk. Two on, two outs.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
The next offering misses, and that's ball three.
Last couple of pitches breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
And a pitch.
Three balls.
Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Stays alive. Righty delivers. Hit hard, base hit. Bam, around third. He'll score easily. It's 11-0.
Back-to-back singles, I'll tell you. Man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
So they're at the corners now. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Ketel Marte. The 1-1 is fouled off. And a pitch. And down on strikes. Definitely not a partay for Ketel Marte. So nine batters come to the plate. Four of them score. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 11 and the Rangers nothing. Welcome back. John Chami with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Jonah Heim. Here's a 2-1. Way high.
Well, these Rangers looking to string together better at bats when they have runners on, but it just hasn't happened for them yet. They've had their chances with runners in scoring position, but no
slides, but he can't come up with it.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
So the Rangers batting order turns over. Next is the designated hitter, Evan Carter.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat. And you got to give some credit to the other side as well. They've been able to get out of a few tough jams, but frustration is mounting for this offense, no doubt.
Yeah. Next pitch misses, and that's ball two. The 2-1. And that's too high.
3-1.
On the ground to third, Longoria. Over to second, and that's two.
I think there's always something pretty about watching a 5-4-3 double play get turned. I mean, just seeing the ball whipped around the diamond with quickness and accuracy, that was nice.
So digging in, Leody Taveras. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
Yeah, the 2-1 hammered, but foul.
This batter has to understand his job is to get on base however he can. If he gets hit by a pitch, if he walks, maybe even singles. But you want to get the heart of the order up to the plate.
And here it comes. Off the mark there. And it's a full count.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with a three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he walked him.
Speaking of walks, did you see anything special during your walk into the ballpark today? I know you like to take in all the surroundings.
I just love interacting with the people. It's just fun to connect. I mean, as I was headed up to the booth, one guy shouted at me, "Make sure to say hi to Kenny." That one misses, 2-1.
Well, if he's going to steal second, you want him to go early in the count. That way he's not a distraction to the hitter at the plate. Go ahead and get it out of the way so the hitter can focus on the pitch.
Not close with that one. Three balls and a strike.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And the 3-1. And a foul ball. And he deals. And down on strikes he goes. And that'll do it. One left for Texas. They trail in this one 11-0. Back here at the ballpark. And now it's going to be Lourdes Gurriel Jr. At the belt and fires. And that one off the outside edge. Activity in the bullpen. Brock Burke up and loosening in the pen. And the right-hander deals. And now it's even up. And now the count filled up 3-2. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Just missed there. Ooh. How would you describe your strike zone?
Kind of like a Weeble. Large. Down the third baseman. Evan Longoria. Hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
All over that one right there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Gabriel Moreno stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Pitch is in there. That is strike two. First and second here, no outs. the other way, and they tag him out.
Well, we assume it, but not all double plays are 6-4 threes or something like that. Right there, it's just sort of a combination of good defense and poor base running, and probably more of the latter. That's a big turn of events in this inning, though.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Jordan Lawler. Next offering is in for a strike. Runner leads away at second. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. So one hit is all they get. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 11 and the Rangers nothing. And welcome back. Well, we go bottom six, and here is Adolis Garcia. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Off the plate inside, two balls and a strike. And a pitch. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Hauls it in for the out.
The batter, number two, second baseman, Marcus Semien.
Here is Marcus Semien. Singing, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
And that one is inside. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. He sends it out of here. His second home run of the series. It's 11-1.
Like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
Torey Lovello is out of the dugout, and he's going to make a move here. Merrill Kelly gives way. Pretty good effort, and he exits with a lead. We'll tell you about the new pitcher when we get back. Joe Mantiply takes over on the mound. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Number 35, Joe Mantiply.
So one out, nobody on. Nathaniel Lowe will hit next. And now the lefty right through there for a strike. Struck him out swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
That left-handed batter facing a left-handed pitcher that's got some sink like that at the end. It's just the bottom falls out of it when it looks like it's going to be a pretty good pitch in that location that everyone says lefties love.
Two outs. Swing and a miss. Bullpen activity starting up now. Kyle Nelson, a lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Number 30, getting cranked up as well. Good eye right there. Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball three. Josh Young up next. So now 3-2 in the air, right field. McCarthy settles under it. And that ends the inning. But a solo home run will at least get this closer to respectability. We're through six full. This is the World Series on the show. Taking over on the mound for the Rangers, Brock Burke.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing team did that to me.
Now it's the right fielder, Jake McCarthy.
The right fielder, Jake McCarthy.
The pitch. In the air, right side. And there's one down.
The center fielder, number 28.
Here's the center fielder, Tommy Pham.
Beautiful swing in his last at bat, opposite field knock.
The 1-1.
Ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Just missed. Bounce to the left side, and it goes just foul.
Well, you put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Runner on at first with one gone. Here's the left fielder, Corbin Carroll. And ball four, two aboard.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, the game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
One down. Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. The 2-1. That's down and in. The pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Pham over at second. Carroll at first. One gone. Pitch fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. That's out to center field. Tavares settles under it, brings it in. That's out number two.
Now batting, second baseman, Ketel Marte.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ketel Marte. 1-1 now. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Runner at third puts on the brakes. Base is now loaded with two away.
Well, just a total nightmare for lefties. I'd be very surprised to see that matchup again. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Now here is Lourdes Gurriel Jr. in the air, right field. Garcia grabs it on the run. Diamondbacks leave them loaded, but they're on autopilot, leading 11-1. Set for the last half of the seventh. Here's the third baseman, Josh Young. Kicks and fires. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Here's the 2-2. Just missed. Got him. One away. Next up for Texas, Jonah Heim. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. Over to first. In time. Nice stretch. Two outs. Base is empty. And now it's the Rangers' leadoff hitter, Evan Carter, 1-for-3. Left-hand hitter waits.
No, that's a ball.
And another ball. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. The pitch. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Longoria flashes the leather on the run and catch. This one pretty well decided at this point. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 11 and the Rangers 1. So out of the bullpen for the Rangers, Josh Spores.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleed and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
And now here is Evan Longoria.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
The 1-1. And that one upstairs.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss. 98 on the gun. And misses. It's a strikeout.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
And a pitch. And there's a foul ball. Thank you. And a swing and a miss.
Back-to-back strikeouts.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter, and I'm so glad I'm retired.
The 1-2. Next offering popped in the air, right field. And that is that. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Kyle Nelson.
And you know, bullpen guys can struggle sometimes when they're called upon with big leads because it just doesn't have the same intensity as a tight game. So we'll see how sharp he is. Your mental toughness matters in situations like this as well.
Now, Leody Taveras. Three-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Looked like a questionable call in that spot. He even seemed a little surprised it went his way at the plate, but as a hitter, you'll take that all day.
And at first, Corey Seager stepping in for the Rangers. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. The 2-2. That one just misses. Activity in the Arizona bullpen. Miguel Castro up and throwing for manager Torey Lovullo. Taveras aboard here at first with nobody out. Center field. Pham under it. Makes the grab. One away.
Up next for the Rangers, the right fielder, Adolis.
So up next, Adolis Garcia. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. So now 1-2. Got him swinging.
Good late cut for the strikeout there. That thing really got in on him. And, you know, the cutter isn't really a huge swing and miss pitch most of the time because it's not really meant to move a whole lot. You're just trying to miss the big part of the barrel and maybe get some weak contact. But that one right there did a whole lot more than that. That was a really good pitch.
3-2 now. And a foul ball. He stays alive. He goes down looking. Rangers leave one. They trail by double digits, 11-1. Welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Leading off, Jake McCarthy.
Jake McCarthy.
Here's a 1-1. That one out to right. Garcia settles under it. And out number one on the grab.
Now batting the center fielder.
So digging in, Tommy Pham. And a 2-1 on the way. And a foul ball. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Two outs, bases empty. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And the righty deals. Fights it off, he'll see another. One and two now. Foul ball left side, he'll see another. Tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. And that's ruled a swing. It's a strikeout. So they go quietly there. 6-7-8 scheduled to start the bottom of the ninth. It's the Diamondbacks 11 and the Rangers 1. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Number 30.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
So digging in, Nathaniel Lowe.
The Rangers, the first baseman, Nathaniel Lowe.
Now fly ball to right center. McCarthy settles under it and puts the squeeze on that. And there's one away.
Now batting, the left fielder.
Now the left fielder, Ezekiel Duran. The 1-1 is fouled off. Struck him out looking.
Well, just excellent location on that inside fastball. Really locked him up. And it's a hitter. It's not typically what you're looking for. You're trying to protect away and then in. So you can be a little bit tardy with two strikes. Hard to tell if he was fooled or if he thought it would be called a ball. But either way, that's a really nice pitch.
And the batter now, Josh Jung. Off the mark there. And it's 2-1. Here comes a pitch. Jack swing went around. And the count is 2-2. Just one strike away. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Lifted in the air out to left. He's got it. Ball game. And the Diamondbacks secure a big road win in game two. They even up the series before heading home.
Well, this team was ready from the first pitch of the ball game. Swinging the bats, scoring runs, just very aggressive. I feel like they set the tone, and that tone created a momentum that took them all the way to the finish line. Nice win today.
So Singy, as the numbers show, a great performance on the mound in this one.
Absolutely, and that really set the tone from the beginning. A fantastic effort.
An 11-1 final. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final line score for the ball game tonight. First for the victorious Diamondbacks, 11 runs on 14 hits. No errors. They left 10 men on base.